Animals and robots balance dynamically by placing their feet into proper ground targets. While foot placement controls exist for both fully robotic systems and powered prostheses, none enable the dynamism and reactiveness of able-bodied humans. A swing-like control approach was recently developed for an ideal, double-pendulum dynamical system that places feet into ground targets for a wide range of initial conditions and in the presence of significant locomotion disturbances. While its performance in simulation make it an attractive candidate to control legged robotic systems, it is unclear if the approach can be used on real-world systems. In this work, we transfer and evaluate the approach on robotic hardware. The proposed swing leg controller is a heuristic control method that achieves foot placements into specified ground targets via combined hip and knee controls. Hip and knee angles are reinterpreted as a length L and angle alpha of a single segment virtual leg, which are modulated by commanded joint torques during swing to make ground contact with the desired angle alpha target. Our hardware platform, Robotic Neuromuscular Leg 2, or RNL2, is used to evaluate the swing leg controller on robotic hardware. The robot has translational compliance at its joints and uses four cable-driven series elastic actuators during swing leg control. A high-fidelity simulation of RNL2 is created as a tool to transfer the proposed swing leg controller to robotic hardware. Its software and control architecture mimic the hardware setup, enabling us to adapt the swing leg controller for real-time execution at 1 kHz. The controller is evaluated with two sets of foot placement experiments: undisturbed motion without obstacles, and disturbed motion with the robot's toe colliding with a 420-gram obstacle mid-swing. The following video shows an example hardware foot placement motion generated by the swing leg controller. Both the simulated and physical RNL2 systems achieve comparable foot placement accuracy to the double pendulum simulation for both undisturbed and disturbed experiments, suggesting that the controller can accurately regulate foot placement of robotic legs. These results suggest that the proposed approach is a potential alternative control method for legged robots and powered prostheses, enabling recovery from sudden swing leg disturbances such as wire trips and unexpected obstacle encounters. Our immediate goal is to transfer the swing leg controller's neuromuscular interpretation to RNL2 in order to investigate benefits of multi-articulation for robotic and prosthetic systems, including more human-like swing leg behavior and segment mass distributions, and modularity for multiple prosthesis configurations. Our ultimate goal is to couple swing and stance controls and investigate the advantages of neuromuscular locomotion controls to robotic hardware.